Hello future engineers, welcome to my YouTube channel. If you are still new to my channel and you like what I'm doing, please don't forget to share my videos to your friends and to your friends' friends. That's one way you can keep me going, inspired and refreshed, and to explore my videos to others so that other individuals, other students, professionals maybe, can explore my YouTube channel, and hopefully it will also help them in their journey as professionals or as students. So this video, lecture video, is all about distributed forces. I hope that you already mastered the calculations of areas, volumes, and arc lengths, and as well as the familiarization of the location of the centroid, so that when we distribute these forces to beams and other structures or structural elements, then it's easy for us, for you, to compute for the reaction forces or the equivalent force. So I hope so. Level 6, determine the reactions at A and B for the beam subjected to the uniform load distribution. So here is the given figure. We will call for the solution, let's call the reaction here, consists of AY and AX is 0, obviously. And we have R sub B here. And the area, because this is rectangular loading, line load, so the equivalent loading, which is the area of this diagram, is at the centroid of this rectangle. So we will call that force F, or in this case W1, the distance from the right to 50 mm, from the left end of the load to 50 mm plus 300, so 550 mm from A. So 250, half of 500 from B, 250 mm. Then the location of W1 from A is 250 plus 300, 550 mm. So summation, let's solve for W1 first. Area, 4 times 0.5 meter, 4 kilonewton per meter times 0.5 meter, so it is 2 kilonewtons. Then summation moments about B equals 0. AY times 800 minus 2 kilonewtons times 250 mm equals 0. So from there, we can solve for AY. It is upward. AX is 0. 0.625 kilonewtons. So AX is 0. So we may also write our answer as reaction at A is 0.625 kilonewtons upward. Likewise, summation moment about B equals 0. R sub B times 800 minus 2 times 550 mm equals 0. So R sub B is equal to 1.375 kilonewtons upward. So that's it for this problem. Level 7, calculate the support reactions at A and B for the loaded beam. So here's the given figure. We'll call the reactions at A as AY, and AX is 0, there's no inclined or horizontal loading. So AY, AX is 0, R sub B. Then let's call this F or W1. The location is 1/3 of 6, so 2 feet from the right, 4 from the 0 end of loading, plus 3, so 7 feet from A. So that's 2 feet, 7 feet from A. Where 7 feet is either 2/3 of 6, 4 plus 3, or simply 3 plus 6, 9 minus 2, so 7 feet. So the W1 is area of this triangle. So it is 1/2 of 6 times 100, and therefore it is 300 pounds. Summation moment about B equals 0. Clockwise positive, so AY times 9 plus 80 times 6 minus 300 times 2 equals 0. So AY is equal to 13.33 pounds, AX is 0, so RA is 13.33 pounds upward. Likewise, summation of moment about A equals 0, counterclockwise positive, RB times 9 plus 80 times 3 minus 300 times 7 equals 0. So R sub B is 206.7 pounds. So that's it for this problem. Level 8 problem. For the beam and loading shown, determine letter A, the magnitude and location of the resultant of the distributed load, and letter B, the reactions at the beam supports. So for the solution, we divide the loading into two parts, two triangles. You can also divide this into rectangle and triangle, but I will divide this into two triangles. You may solve this again by dividing the loading distribution into two, one rectangle and the other triangle if you want. So I'll just divide it in two triangles, triangular loading. So call this weight 1, the area of this smaller triangle, and weight 2, the area of this bigger triangle. The location of W1 from the left end A is 1/3 of 6, 2. And from the right 4, I will not show it anymore. For W2, the distance from the right is 1/3 of 6, so 2 meters from here, 4 meters from A, as shown. So the resultant of this loading is somewhere in between but closer to W2, as shown. We will call that resultant of the loading as W. And its distance from the left end A is XG, as indicated in the figure. So W1, area of the triangle, 1/2 of 6 meters times 400. And for the reaction, we have AY, AX 0, and there is moment which is assumed to be counterclockwise, which is supposedly to oppose the moment of the resultant W. So that would be expected correct direction. So W1 again is area of triangle 1/2 of 6 times 400. That's 1,200 newtons. W2 is 1/2 of perpendicular dimension. So 1/2 of 6 times 1,600. And it is 4,800 newtons. Therefore, the resultant, the magnitude of the resultant W is the W1 plus W2, and it is downward. 1,200 plus 4,800, so it is 6,000 newtons downward. For the reactions, summation versus Y equals 0, AX is automatic 0, so AY equals W, and summation of moment for the location rather by Vrigdon's theorem, W times XG or 6,000 times XG is equal to the sum of the moments of its components. So equals W1, 1,200 times 2 plus W2, 4,800 times 4. So XG is 3.6 meters to the right of A. Then for the reactions, so solving for AY, summation versus Y, AY is W. So RA therefore is equal to 6,000 newtons upward, which is equal to AY because AX is 0. Then for the moment reactions, MA, so MA equals W times 3.6 because XG has been found 3.6 meters. So MA is 6,000 times 3.6. MA is 21,600 newton meter counterclockwise. Level 9 problem. For the beam and loading shown, determine letter A, the magnitude and location of the resultant of the distributed load. B, the reactions at the beam supports. So here is the given figure. For the solution, let's divide the loading into two parts, rectangular loading and spandrel of parabola. So we will call the equivalent loading on the rectangular portion, the area which is W1, and for this spandrel of parabola W2. By the way, because it is a rectangle, the location is the centroid of that rectangle is half of 6, 3 meters from A, 3 meters from B. For this parabolic loading, W2, the location is 1/4, because this is second degree parabola, 1/4 of 6, so that's 1.5 meters. So 4.5 from the right. Then the resultant to be somewhere in between here, and we will call that W, and the location from A is XG as shown. So for W1, it's just area 6 meters times 900 newtons per meter, so it is 5400 newtons. For W2, area of spandrel of parabola 1/3 of 6 meters by, it's no longer 2000 minus 900, so 1100. W2 is 1/3 of 6 meters times 1100 newton per meter, so 2200 newtons. Therefore, W is 5400 plus 2200, so it is 7600 newtons downward. Then for its location, by Varignon's theorem, W times XG equals the sum of moments of its components. So 7600 XG equals 5400 times 3 plus 2200 times 1.5. So XG is equal to 2.566 meters to the right of A. Then for the reactions, we have AY, AX0, so RA is equal to AY, and we have R sub B. Summation moments about B equals 0, clockwise positive. So we have AY times 6 minus W, which is 7600. The distance from the right is 6 meters minus XG. So 7600 quantity 6 minus XG equals 0. So AY is equal to 4350 newtons. Therefore, RA is 4350 newtons, which is equal to AY, because AX is 0 upward. So for AY equals 4350 newtons upward. For RB, summation moment about A equals 0. So R sub B times 6 minus 7600 times XG, which is 2.566, equals 0. So R sub B is equal to 3 to 50 newtons upward. So that's it for this level 9 problem. So level 10, this is by approximation, and we use Simpson's 1/3 rule here so that you will be familiar, or so that you can review with the formulas for Simpson's 1/3 rule. I'm going to derive it first. So the beam carries the distributed line load shown. Use numerical integration to determine the resultant force and its line of action. So here is the given beam, and this is the loading, which varies without a pattern. So that's why we have to use numerical integration, specifically Simpson's 1/3 rule. And for the solution, we will call this HO. H1, this offset. H2, H3, H4, ... HN. So this should be H5, because there will only be 6 offsets beginning with HO. The uniform distance is D, as shown. So remember the principle that for Simpson's 1/3 rule, the excess area bounded by the line joining HO and H2 is treated as a parabola, as shown. So that's a, we have trapezoid, and this is parabola. The remaining height, because the straight line cuts H1 into average of HO and H2, so therefore, this very small height of the parabola is H1 minus quantity HO plus H2 over 2. So again, that's H1 minus quantity HO plus H2 over 2, the average, of course, because that's a straight line. While this height of the parabola here is H3 minus average of H2 and H4. So H3 minus quantity H2 plus H4 over 2. So the area, considering this part only, and we will generalize the result later because that should also be continued. So area equals area of trapezoid 1 half of HO plus H2 times 2D plus area of parabola 2 thirds of 2D times height H1 minus HO over 2 minus H2 over 2. So this is the height, which is simplified in this manner. Plus this area here, area of trapezoid 1 half of quantity H2 plus H4 times 2D plus the area of parabola, which is 2 thirds of 2D times quantity H3 minus H2 over 2 minus H4 over 4 over 2. So simplifying, we have HOD plus H2D plus 4 thirds DH1 minus 2 thirds DHO minus 2 thirds DH2 plus H2D plus H4D plus 4 thirds DH3 minus 2 thirds DH2 minus 2 thirds DH4 and so on and so forth. Okay. Because supposedly there is extension here. So studying these terms, first HO combined like terms, we have HO minus 2 thirds of HOD minus 2 thirds of HOD. That would be 1 third of HOD. So area is HOD over 3. Then we have 4 thirds H1D. Then H2D minus 2 thirds H2D is 1 third H2D. Plus H2D, so 4 thirds H2D minus 2 thirds H2D is 2 thirds H2D. So that's why we have 2 thirds H2D here. For H3D, we have 4 thirds H3D. Then for H4D, we have H4D minus 2 thirds of H4D. H4D minus 2 thirds of H4D is 1 third of H4D, but this is 2 thirds because there is pattern already that if the H is even, the coefficient is 2 thirds. The result here is 1 third of H4D, but remember if we extend it, this H4 is again involved in the calculation of area of trapezoid and portion of the parabola. So that's why it is expected that the coefficient of H4D is 2 thirds, just like the coefficient of H2D here, which is an even offset, is 2 thirds. And for the odd offsets such as H1, H3, H5, and so on, intermediate offsets which add is 4 times the 4 over 3 times odd offsets. So in general, factor out constant interval over 3. So area is D over 3, quantity HO plus 4 times summation of H odd offsets plus 2 times summation of H even offsets. These are intermediate offsets excluding HO and HN, regardless of HO and HN will be odd or even. So these are intermediate offsets. So this is the general formula by Simpson's 1/3 rule for the area. And we need that in computing the approximate way of computing this area. And this is Simpson's 1/3 rule. So therefore, area is D, which is 2.5 here. 2.5 over 3, quantity 42.5 plus 4 times 37.5 plus 32.4 plus 52.1, which is 85. These are odd offsets, plus 2 times even offsets, 82, which is 28.3, and 84 only, excluding 86, because that's the end. That's the end offset. So only 82 and 84 are the intermediate offset. So times 2 from this formula here, then plus HN, which is 58.6. So using your calculator, solving for area, area is equal to 608.58, and the unit would be pounds, because this is W pounds per foot times length feet, therefore it is in pounds. And it is located somewhere there, and we will call the distance. So R equals A equals 608.6 pounds, that's the resultant. And it is located at XG from the left. So for computing XG, the moment of the resultant about the left is R times XG, and it is equal to the sum of the moments of its components. So in general also, it is HO times 0D, because the moment arm is 0, plus this is times 4. So 4 times H1 times moment arm 1D. So R times XG equals D over 3 quantity HO times 0D plus 4 times H1 times 1D plus 2 times H2 times 2D plus 4 times H3 times 3D plus 2 times H4 4D plus H sub N times ND. So notice that if the subscript of the height is 1, then the moment arm is 1D. Subscript 2, the moment arm is 2D. Subscript 3, the moment arm is 3D, and so on, that pattern there. So substituting, R is 608.6 times XG equals 2.5 over 3 quantity 42.50 plus 4 times H1 37.5 times D for 2.5, the moment arm, plus 2 times 28.3 times 5, 2D, plus 4 times 32.4 times 7.5, plus 2 times 42.3 times 10, plus 4 times again 52.1 times 12.5, plus lastly 58.6 times 15, HN times 15. So divide everything by 608.6, we can now compute XG. And XG, 608.6 XG is equal to, the value of the right side is 40905 over 3. So X sub G is equal to 8.164 feet. So the resultant is 608.6 pounds downward, and it is located at 8.164 feet to the right of the left end. So that's it for this numerical integration, numerical calculations. Familiar with the Simpson's one-third rule, there are problems where we need to compute the value by approximation, because loadings may have not a pattern or an equation. So we use numerical integration.